the history of America, a great nation with a powerful historical background. Despite the many civil conflicts that portrays the way we look at the country today, the many key issues have been visualized through the historical films throughout the centuries as a way to reflect on the key events, although some historical films have raised concerns about the relative historical content that has been exploited within these motion pictures. Throughout different decades, the way African American people throughout the Civil Rights era have been portrayed have changed vastly throughout time. In the late 1980s, director Alan Parker released the Southern-focused racial segregation film known as Mississippi Burning. The crime-historical-based film is set in the 1960s in the southern state of America, where two FBI agents were sent to investigate the missing civil rights activists. The film shows us the aspects of the southern treatment towards African Americans, visualizing high levels of racial segregation experienced by black Americans, including activities involved by the white supremacy group the Ku Klux Klan, including potential threats to African American families if any of them spoke to the FBI agents. The film utilizes a white savior from the northern states of America to bring justice to these civil rights activists as they are found dead in the state of Mississippi. The use of a white savior, also known as an anti-racist white hero, mentioned in Jennifer Pierce's filming Racial Progress, The Transition of a White Male Innocent. The article mentions that the civil rights era created an identity crisis for the whites by redefining the image of black self for white America. As this is not relatively shown in the southern sectors of the country, Mississippi Burning allows the viewers to understand and acknowledge the racial segregation within the South, as well as the different ways African Americans are treated by whites from the sectors of America. As a historical film is defined as a motion picture in which engages with historical issues through the presentation of major key turning events, Mississippi Burning is a historical film to the extent that it only contains historical themes and produced into a dramatic film without any relation to historical events. As Hollywood produces more and more civil rights films, they have focused merely on the historical personalities that have influenced America to change their political views with African Americans. Spike Lee's 1992 film Malcolm X is a biographical drama film focusing on the life of one of the most influential civil rights activists. The film focuses on Malcolm X's life, focusing on the lifestyle change he had undertaken, going from a hustler into an inspirational speaker for African Americans across the country. The film, however, focuses not as much on the inspirational speaking side of his life in comparison to the hustling gang lifestyle, but the film does actually reenact the major events in his life, as the film itself is an adaptation to the autobiography of Malcolm X. Mentioned in Gordon E. Slothog's edit in Spike Lee, Martin Luther King, Malcolm X, The Politics of Domination and Difference, he discusses how the film is a dramatic adaptation to the autobiography of Malcolm X, and the director has created a similar dialogue between Malcolm X's black rage, nationalism, and King-like awareness of the devastating consequences of black militancy. The film includes several flashbacks to his early childhood, which addresses the concerns of the way African Americans are treated as he is living in the South, with his parents dealing with an unfair loss of his father, as he was believed to have committed suicide, supposedly hitting himself in the back of the head and being left for dead on the light rail tracks, getting hit by a train. The factors of Malcolm X's past explicitly influences the way he works towards the rights for black people, which allows Spike Lee's Malcolm X to be considered a historical film. Despite being dramatized for his autobiography, the film itself shows the viewers the story of his life, focusing on the key events of the civil rights movement, as well as his influential contribution to racial equality. The lifestyle of different people can have different perspectives when it comes to a political movement or era, whether they are the same color of skin or not. Lee Daniels' 2013 film The Butler explores the story of an African-American butler serving in the White House over a vast array of decades. The film is based on the story of Eugene Allen, the actual butler that had served in the White House for 8 different presidents, including Dwight D. Eisenhower, played by Robin Williams, John F. Kennedy, and Richard Nixon. The historical film goes through the horrific events that have occurred within America, including the influence of the Student Nonviolent Coordinating Committee and the Black Panther Party, which involved the butler's son. The butler, Cecil Gaines, in the movie during his childhood, was working as a slave in a cotton farm when he was taken by one of the masters to be trained as what Malcolm X calls a house negro. Throughout the time of his life, the butler takes different steps in life leading up to the offer to work within the walls of the White House. The film explores several different themes, not only exploring the moments of civil rights movement, including acceptance of black servitude and the relationship and conflict of different perspectives within the bloodline, discussing Cassandra Chancy's A Qualitative Examination of African Self-Conscious and Bernard Beck's What the Butler Saw, Lee Daniels' studies in biographical history. The authors have discussed the interpretation people are getting about the film, as well as the way the movie is representing African Americans. While there are examples within the movie that are treated as unique cultural value, several viewers had argued the fact that they are sick and tired of seeing slavery films and films that visualize African American people to be servants due to the fact that it reinterprets the stereotypes that are set against the black Americans today. Despite the film not being entirely true when it comes to Cecil Gaines' son Lewis, civil rights groups, the film offers a textual look at the story of a working class black man and the steep personal cost paid to raise a family during the age of racial apartheid in America, including the sacrifices made by those who try to make a change within the political system of America. Lee Daniels' The Butler is to be considered a good historical film, despite several aspects to the film that are not entirely based on fact. The film does, however, explore the themes of racial segregation, as well as the key events that had contributed towards the civil rights movement in the late 1900s. So, the main question is, what do these movies tell us about the attitudes of race over time? The three films over 3 decades has shown us the dramatic change within the North sector of America when it comes to the treatment and the attitudes of African Americans over time. The treatment itself, however, revolves around the change in political rights involving the 1965 Voting Rights Act and the general civil rights of all African American people. Now we come here.